So you've described the party as centrist, that yes. You, kumbaga, inamin mo na posibleng magulat ka sa mga posible pang sumali at sumuporta sa partido, no, at sa grupo. Just recently, Manila Mayor Isko Moreno has said openly that he does want President Duterte's endorsement. What do you make of that?
Karen, he has told me, and I'm also questioning, diba? I'm asking him, syempre, I was known, no? I was known as a critic. President Duterte is a voter, which, o nga naman, he's a voter, diba? And I also, as a human being, as a candidate of Marawi, would need the vote of everyone. And o nga no, President, President Chabal Isko, you need also President Duterte. And if he asked for his endorsement, then that's his level of that's level of need. And for me, I'm very grateful if in case, but I'm not asking for it actively, Ma'am Karen. I'm doing my campaign. I'm doing as many messaging as I can on women, children, and my narrative of war. I mean, and in this environment, Ma'am Karen, Russia, Ukraine, talaga pong lalo pa ako nakukompel, and if there's the bashing, then let me take it in. Thank you po for the bashing, but please let's go to the core of all the valuable things that are needed right now. Crisis management, international relations, national relations, which I think I can add to in the narrative telling.
So Samira, if President Duterte endorses you, for example, you would take it and you would want it?
I did not solicit, but I'm very grateful, if ever.
Okay. Now, recently also, Mr. Moreno lambasted the Liberal Party, claiming that LP tried to oust Duterte. Now, do you believe this? Frankly speaking, you once ran with the Liberal Party.
You know, ma'am, at the 2019, we felt as LP that we were lambasted to the max, not by Isko, but all this troll farms, all these factors outside our control as Liberal Party. Na 2019, we were the senatorial candidates, and the sentiment ni Isko that there are also belittling of him. He is not of the quality of a presidential. I mean, these are feelings he had ever since, di ba po, when you interviewed me, Karen, or in the last time na I was standing beside him, and he had these feelings about the Liberal Party, Vice President Lenny, about the unity talks. So these are sentiments that he carries since then, the unity talks of past months ago, Ma'am Karen, that I wasn't privy to. So the outright lambasting could have been, you know, like a sentiment that he has carried over since then. But I would say this is election fever na, Ma'am Karen.
That's a serious accusation. I mean, your presidential candidate essentially said that the Liberal Party tried to oust Duterte, a legitimate winner with 16 million votes. So I'm saying that accusation shouldn't be taken lightly. My first question is, do you believe that the Liberal Party actually tried to oust Duterte?
Well, ma'am, you know, at that heat of moment, that wasn't processed with us, you know, because in this heat of interviews, talagang dire-diretso po kami, Ma'am Karen.
But I'm asking you now, do you believe that the LP tried to oust Duterte?
Vice President, well, having been in that specific way with VP Lenny, I couldn't really determine, or she wasn't really like overtly, ma'am. I wasn't part of any core meetings on that effect, ma'am, when I was with them.
Okay, so you are saying that you are taking Mayor Moreno's sentiment to a degree as truth.
That's his sentiment. Let me just take it at that.
The reason I'm asking is, you do have netizens asking, why didn't Samira even correct that? You once ran with LP. You had similar ideologies and values at one point. If it's something that is inaccurate, something without basis, why wouldn't Samira correct something like that?
I wasn't consulted on such sentiment, but yeah, we will have that moment to talk.
Okay, all right. Now, is it worth it, Samira? I mean, clearly, when I interviewed you on Head Start, I remember this was in October 2021. You said you couldn't wait anymore. You didn't know if VP Lenny was running. So when you were invited by Mayor Isko, you had agreed. But now that clearly Mayor Isko wants Duterte's endorsement, you have Mocha Uson campaigning with you on stage, you have your original supporters, your original Samira Gutok fans or followers, so to speak, who are now, you know, not feeling or supporting you in the same manner. So, Samira, is it worth it for you?
Very, very humbled, Ma'am Karen, that you're even able to give me this moment to say to the supporters, and this might be that moment that I can get back to them, and some of them are getting back to me, that whatever it is, my journey, my decision, my process, they will respect. Ma'am Karen, let me open my heart to you, to everyone, my supporters. Now, I won't never say former. Please give me a chance to talk to you. Call me, messenger me. You know, hindi tayo nakasama for 3 years, physically every day. So I know that you will understand when we get to talk. This is the journey that I've taken. It was Sambayan who was there with me. We were organizing for VP Lenny before Action Democratico. So, you know, this was the process that has taken me to that evolution by Action, that I was invited to the national leadership, and then it decided on Isko, Ma'am Karen. So, you know, there's no, I know for me, it's not a, of course, it's conflictual at one point, but I had to make certain decisions. Mm-mm.
But then how do you, I mean, are you ever conflicted yourself today? I mean, frankly speaking?
No, Karen, ano, putting out my heart there. Siyempre, ma'am, nahihirapan ako minsan. Nahihirapan ako, pero kasi, ma'am, this is about crisis. And I stand with my presidential Isko that he has fought to the limit as a basurero, fighting stereotypes. Mm-hmm. I'm a bakwit, he's a basurero. Mm-hmm. I mean, the stories are so aligned. And sana po, if in case, ma'am Karen, you and I, as media, I mean, if I join media, if I lose this game, so-called election, is I get back to educating people on political party building. Kailangan po mas steady po kami as candidates on where we stand para tinitingnan po ang issue rather than personalities. Mm-hmm. Like Samira is not Samira, but Samira is for what she stands for, on peace, on women, and on rights rather than her mistakes.
So you consider this a mistake? Is that what you're saying?
I mean, for the mistakes that are perceived by the public, like this for followers, some followers is seen as like Mocha beside me, na hindi ko kinokorekta yung ganong situation where we're already in that heat of the moment. So yes, Ma'am Karen, I mean, for them it might be a mistake, but for me, I had to just accept the moment as it is.
All right, let's talk about policy. Manila Mayor Isko Moreno says that if he wins, he won't hand over President Duterte to the ICC if he is convicted, but he is open to an investigation with the ICC. Do you stand by this same policy too?
I stand with this, with the aligned position that exhausts the remedies of having our country's legal system support an ICC procedure. Mm-hmm. So he wants the physical presence of that investigation to be here in the country so that, you know, as a senior citizen, see President Duterte, they're able to be able to, you know, look at the stages of what is going on, no?
All right. Okay. But you do agree with Mayor Moreno that, not for the Philippine government to hand over President Duterte if convicted. You agree with that?
Well, it's an ICC process. So, you know, as an international studies student, I will respect, no, yung procedural process.
Okay. Now, I'll give you an opportunity to clarify this today. We last spoke on October 2021, and out of that interview, when I asked you what do you consider as President Duterte's biggest achievement, I guess it's actually a long soundbite, but you did say drugs could be the deaths. EJ case are astoundingly appalling. Yes, peace and order in a way, but the deaths are from it, so warranting of questioning and investigation. And then you said achievement, or maybe just the only one that is remarkable, rememberable. And you got hit for those yes, statements. So yes, I want to ask you again, what do you really think of President Duterte's drug war?
Still wanting of investigation, still wanting of programming for the victims. That's which, where I stand. It's an addiction. Drug addiction has to be addressed more at the core, and rehabilitation at the core of funding. So we work with the PNP, ma'am, and the Army in my location in Mindanao on advisorship. And it's really about putting up the institutional orders that will bring drug problem to a minimum, root at the core, the drug shipments stop. Yeah,
but would you consider now the drug war an achievement or a failure?
Not yet, ma'am. Of course it can. It's a step-by-step process. It can't be said fully as a success, as an advocacy, yes. But the process of addressing the youth, the drug rehabilitation program, it's not, no. It's not a success.
But to what degree you agree with the drug war?
It should be a program, ma'am. It's a project that we're doing in the community.
So the implementation for you is wrong?
Yeah. The implementation on having... on having extrajudicial killings, definitely warranting of investigation.
Okay, so what would you recommend to Manila Mayor Isko Moreno if he wins on how to handle the drug war?
Strengthen Philippine Navy presence so that it can check on shipments. Strengthen the budget on drug rehabilitation or enhance it. Strengthen the National Youth Commission's partnership with the PNP and the Philippine Army.
Okay, so what would you now consider as this administration's achievement?
At my knowledge, it's the Bangsamoro Organic Law, the signing. We are seeing the fruits of it. The MILF, the rebels, women and men are already training to become government workers. They're training to put themselves the arms work to desk work. I mean, these are very, very sensitive management skills by former rebels to do. So moral governance at work is something talagang complicated, ma'am. Nakikita ko yan, kay dito po tayo galing. So yeah, it's the Bangsamoro Organic Law. At my knowledge, personal information and witness.
Okay, and I think last Friday was the anniversary of the Jabina massacre 54 years ago. Samira, so let's talk about that. Do you believe, it's considering it's been 54 years, what is wanting in terms of true justice for those who died on that day?
The claims board reported, some official told me that hindi masyado nakaklaim yung martial law victims of the 1970s from the Moro Rebellion, from the martial law in Mindanao. And so that has to be redressed, setting up a bill. That bill is pending, the Transitional Justice Reconciliation, which will address victims of conflict, victims of war, telling of the narratives of the victims, putting it into DepEdShed and into markers, Ma'am Karen.
Okay, so ang sinasabi nga po ninyo, itong maging, mga naging biktima, no? Nung Jabina massacre, kahit siguro yung kanilang kapamilya, ang nangyari, hindi po sila kabilang doon sa May Marcos Compensation Act today ng human rights victims. Hindi po sila kasama doon.
Because lacking of physical documentation daw sa kanilang damage or yung kanilang ruin or the burial or the death of their family.
And what would you do if you win as Senator Samira to correct this?
Push up the TJRC bill. Put that documentation or interview process into motion.
After 54 years, I mean, how do you feel that no one's really been made accountable for this?
Very emotionally invested, ma'am, Karen. Kaya po, whatever the bashing is, it's little, so little compared to the damage of pregnant women being killed along the way and in massacres and mosques. So, maliit po itong aking nararanasan na pain compared to the elders and ancestors and my grand relatives, grand uncles, walking across forests and being killed.
But the Jabina massacre itself, you're reading articles today that during the anniversary, there's an article from a columnist that even said it was a hoax. So kasi nga, ma'am, you see that, when you see that kind of information.
Kasi ma'am, there's nga that quick burial eh. Quick burial of a dead one sa Muslim culture, Muslim tradition. So kaya doon kami nagkandahira pa Moros Muslims na hindi kami nakaka-claim sa claims board kasi direct burial, hindi na do-document na pipicture. Walang social media nga at that time. So yes, given na po yun ma'am that when there's no body, there's no information, there's no evidence. So talagang given yung mga ganyang articles, testimonies to discredit Jabida.
Okay. And being, of course, an activist, no, for the Muslim people, do you feel, Samira, that these are one of the crimes against the late dictator, former President Marcos, that hasn't been really highlighted?
It's a whole machinery, Ma'am Karen. It's a whole machinery of the defense up to the commander that they have to explain to a people, to a community, why the longest rebellion happened. It's because it's rooted at that decision to have bombings, to have shootings and exchange of fire in Mindanao.
Mm. Okay, so go on.
Yeah, that feeds us that we are activists who fought in our college years against discrimination, against the burning of such Jabida memory. And I thank the Anak Mindanao Party for institutionalizing the memory telling in Corregidor, March 18th. So thank you, Ma'am Karen, that I'm able to remind DepEd and national libraries and all provinces, please commemorate Moro with us, Jabida. It's not only us Moros.
Mm. Now, you know, Samira, I've known you for many, many years. I mean, I think I have to be transparent on television with this. And this is what you're known for. This has been your advocacy for life. And yet the truth is, people aren't seeing you in this manner. I've read some netizens say you've become a traditional politician. So they're now seeing you for the other choices you've made, right? These other supposed compromises that you've had to take. How do you then recover from something like that, Samira? What really catapulted you to some kind of national fame is the fact that here's a young woman from Mindanao who is extremely articulate, fluent, uncompromised, and is now on the national stage. And now you have supporters calling you Trapo Samira. I'm sure nakita mo yun.
I'll take it in, Ma'am Karen, kasi po, ang tatlong C na dinadala natin, crisis, kalamidad, COVID-19 as a wife, mother, hindi po yan mawawala sa bawat Pilipino. So, being perceived this way, I hope they'll give me a chance, no? To serve them, I've proven it naman with track record, Ma'am Karen.
Mm-mm-mm. So you are asking for a chance again. You are courting, in a way, your old supporters.
Old supporters, new supporters, even Duterte supporters, sana makita nyo ako for being someone who stood in front of funeral parlors. Wala siguro, Ma'am Karen, konting tayo ng bangko. Sinong taong will catch literally a bullet in front of hostages, in front of terrorists, Ma'am Karen? Nobody, no candidate can tell it as I can.
Okay. Now, in the last presidential debate, candidates actually tackled the 200 billion pesos estate taxes that the BIR is demanding that the Marcos family pays. And your candidate, Manila Mayor Isko Moreno, actually scored some points in that debate by being specific about wanting collecting the 200 billion and where to put the 200 billion. So I want to ask you about that.
I recall, Ma'am Karen, in ARM, ang laki talaga ng deductions, no, sa ating mga ARM payables as sectoral representatives. So that mind-boggling amount really has its social pwede ma-translate into social delivery funding. So yes, ma'am, it should be collectible. It's asserted by us activists ever since yung mga wealth na kailangan imbestigahan sa Marcos administration, and to continue, of course. And this is a very concrete form when we ask the BIR to assert and to keep on following up the collection.
Uh-oh. Would it be fair to say, during this campaign, between Marcos and Duterte, who do you feel is the better candidate? Of course, the president is not a candidate, but between the two, although they are part of unit team, so to speak, but between the two, sino ang mas kaya ni Samira?
Sara VP?
No. I mean, the Duterte administration, which you criticized, and now, of course, you do have Manila Mayor Isko Moreno, more or less, not criticizing this administration, but criticizing Marcos, his fellow candidate. Between the two, sino para sa'yo ang mas kaya mo sa dalawa? Si Pangulong Duterte o si Bongbong Marcos?
Oh, wow. That's a difficult question because I don't know Marcos as a national official. Senator, yes, but Duterte is more clear and transparent with his excesses and his mistakes. So it's easier to talk to somebody who knows and who talks his mind.
All right. Okay. What would happen if Senator Marcos wins? I mean, let's face it, he is the front runner. Now at 55% in the latest survey I've seen, with Pulse Asia even hitting 60. Para sa isang Samira Gutok, anong kahulugan po nun?
Well, centrist pa rin naman. Action is centrist. I'm a centrist. I have to work on COVID crisis calamity. And if President Bong Marcos, presidential, will be the president, then we'll have to work on that. I mean, continues ang aming problema sa Mindanao on poverty. So I have to work with him.
Here's a controversial one for you. You are a women's advocate for women's rights all these years. Senatorial Bet Luke Espiritu recently made news when he said on Head Start that frankly he believes that abortion should be decriminalized. What are your thoughts on that, Samira?
Abortion, ma'am, I know that teenage pregnancy is... young women pregnancies, it's a reality of the day, and many can't take responsibility. They, nako ma'am, ilang nakita nating incidents, iniiwanan sa toilet, iniiwanan sa kung saan-saan yung fetus, to the shock of us, nadidishock na nga tayo abortion shouldn't be something that is optional, or abortion should be as freely offered as many as other countries. No, of course not. I would always echo the civil code. Our family is our institution, primacy of children, primacy of our life as human beings. So it won't be promoted, ma'am. I won't be promoting abortion, even if I'm a feminist, but it shouldn't be as accessible as well. It should be for a very, very, And this is what still I study, is exceptional circumstances, because I know even from my Muslim faith, if it's the woman, and I read through our law readings, woman's life is at risk, abortion can be justified. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so is that the only instance where you believe abortion can be justified? Because the question is, do you believe it should be decriminalized?
Well, it's something that's still up to talks, of course. I consult our women's groups. It's something that is of sensitive, that the Catholic Church has very strong positions on this. But I know in my reading, in my thinking, it shouldn't be as accessible, but it should be for certain instances. And one of which is what I mentioned.
Mm-mm. Okay. And Samira, if you win, would you support divorce? Is it high time to already have divorce in the Philippines?
Ma'am Karen, respeto po sa ating church, but I saw in the 2019 and even as a woman's organizer across the country, nahirapan po sila sa ngayon yung present na annulment and all the legal procedures na napakabagal po as solo parents. Hindi nila makuha yung papel para sila ay maka-justify na DSWD beneficiary po sila. A divorce fast tracks that circumstance na inabandon na sila, iniwanan na po sila. Kasi yung documentation can be fast-tracked.
Oo. So Samira Gutok is pro-divorce?
She, with the circumstances, with the realities na po.
Okay. What about same-sex marriage? I mean, that would be far off, of course. But then it's been asked in so many forums. Let's start first with the Soji Bill. If you win, madaming senador ang may agam-agam sa Soji Bill, they prefer a wider anti-discrimination bill. the SOGI bill is really targeted to the LGBTQ plus community. Would you support that?
Transparent ako, Ma'am Karen, to the LGBT community na same-sex marriage, siguro nakita naman nila itong nasa ulo ko, that it's something that I cannot accept openly. I am for anti-discrimination. I stood for anti-hate crimes po sa amin sa Mindanao, mm-hmm. in the Muslim areas. I push also, ma'am, for recognition of the civil code rights ng bawat property owner ng couple of the same gender. So yun po yung aking gusto rin pang paipalam sa LGBT. While I cannot support same-sex marriage, I will want that your property rights to each other are respected, kasi minsan nililin lang po yung gay na masyadong nagmahal sa isang partner na lalaki.
Oo. It's quite interesting because a candidate's faith, so to speak, really plays a role in their decision-making, no? Kung ano man ang pananampalataya ng isang kandidato, kahit papaano, may papel yun sa pagdesisyon nila. So, para sa'yo, Samira, what do you think then of the separation of church and state? How big of a role will your being Muslim and your own personal faith play in the laws you'll pass and essentially the bills you'll vote for?
Ma'am, I'm a Muslim who lives in a democratic country where LGBTs exist. And in my mind, in the Islamic faith, LGBTs have been said to be not exist, you know, in the discourse na popular. Although sabi nga natin, Islam is democratic in a way, that is still the discussions up for discussions. So Ma'am Karen, I'm I'm part of this organization of Muslims who are understanding the religion amidst the democracy, the complexity of the world. And I am running for a national election. I am a Filipina who is under this flag. At alam ko po, nag-aral batas po ako. And I am recognizing I'm Muslim in my faith, but these laws are still guarded by our Philippine Constitution. Yan po ang ating benchmark.
Mm-hmm. Okay, another question related to women, the RH law. Alam naman natin na ipasa na yon, the Reproductive Health Law, pero ang problema ay pwede kasing hindi yun bigyan ng pondo eh. At ang
yes,
sa
ma'am.
RH law is you'll have options for family planning, such as popondohan dapat ng gobyerno ang pagbili ng condoms, pills at iba pang pamamaraan for family planning para ang mahirap ay hindi kailangang bumili. Dapat libre yon. And we know for a fact that there's not enough funding for that, right? So it's strong on paper but not really in implementation. May mga kandidato kasi who don't believe in funding the RH law in that manner. What about you, Samira?
Ma'am, dagdag po ako sa boses na pro. Suportahan po yung education on RH, the RH law in letter. Kasi po, ako yung author po, isang co-author sa ARM, which is the highest in infant fertility, in mother's fertility rate. So normal sa amin po, Ma'am Karen, yung 10 ang anak. At nakita natin po sa napakaraming settler, urban centers, gaano po karami ang bata, children, and malnourishment, bansot ang ating mga anak. So, no, I will not say that RH should not be supported. Definitely, I'm on the other end. I will say, as a woman, kayo po ay dapat sumuporta sana po sa funding RH mechanisms, RH access.
All right. Samira, speak with the voters. Why should they consider you? Why should they vote for you? And the supporters who felt you've shifted alliances, changed values, your ideologies, what do you want to say to them?
Ma'am Karen, I'm just grateful. Salamat po sa Pilipinong Butante, sa lahat ng nagbigay sa akin ng 2019 na suporta. Again, hindi po ako nag-iba. This is the first moment that I will say that it was a very difficult decision to not accept to be on the other side of the number one in the survey. Siguro, sasabihin ko na yan, Ma'am Karen, I could have been invited to the other group, but I made a position and I told it to the Bong supporters, Marcos supporters, why I cannot be there. So I chose this path, I chose this journey. I was very transparent in, I think, your show or in the other shows, na ang hirap po, even with tarpaulining, ang gastos ng isang bakwit na leader gaya ko. At siguro sa isang basurero na naging former basurero, nasa isang aksyon na centrist group na kung saan iba't iba ay mag-a-address sa COVID, na pinakita ng Diyos may kapal ang napakahirap na dinaanan ng mayaman at mahirap. I am standing for all, even if you don't belong to my political ideology. Tayo ay lilibing ng pareho. So I'm here. Let me be that instrument to bury you with honor, to keep the health afloat, to keep war victims, drug victims with the necessary medical attention. I will be your voice. Hindi po ako nag-iba. Please take that as it is. And these elections will end soon anyway. So happy Ramadan to all the Muslims in a few days. Happy Lent to everyone. And to all those who'd lost a loved one, condolence po. Deepest condolence.
On that note, Samira Gutok, thank you for joining me today. And good luck to you, ma'am.
God first.